Welcome back to my channel. I'm Urvashi. So in this look I created foxy eyeliner look that is really trending nowadays, and I tried to add a bit of glitter in this. So finally it is looking like this. Today I was thinking to go a little, you know, out there kind of makeup look that is suitable for any, you know, festive season or wedding guest look maybe. So this look I created using all the drugstore products. Okay, now if you are wondering that it is looking really intrigued and I have taken my full blown time to create it, so it is not the case. You can create this very easily. I think you can create this very easily without thinking and putting too much of efforts. I just created a bit of the foxy liner and then added a bit of, you know, shimmer to it. And that is this one from Blue Heaven that I got recently. So it is completely a silver shimmer dust, I think. So it really makes a difference and it is taking the look up to that level. So if you like this one, you can try creating this with your own available stuff. And if you recreate, please do not forget to tag me on Instagram. My handle is urvashi_singh. I will pop that up on the screen somewhere. Please follow me there for more personal updates and some nice pictures. Hope you like this one too, and if you do, please let me know in the comment section below. Also, do not forget to like this video, subscribe to my channel and share with your family and friends. If you like this look, please continue watching. I am starting up with a toner, and this one is from Khadi Natural Herbal Roast Water Toner. I just took out few drops of the toner and just patting it all over my face. To moisturize my face, I took Pond Super Light Gel Moisturizer. This one is with hyaluronic acid and vitamin E. This one is really light in texture and it is almost like gel-like. You don't feel like applying any kind of heavy moisturizer. So now to prep further, I took my Color Bar's Absolute Primer. And this is a silicone based primer that will blur out all the pores and will minimize any pores if you have any huge pores on your face. So basically I'm applying on my T-zone and then patting it in. Then it is time to color correct. For that I took my Swiss Beauty's concealer in the darker shade. This one is in the shade Warm. So you see, I just applied this on the areas where I have hyperpigmentation, like my under eyes and around my mouth. So this will cancel out any darkness there. I blended that out using only my fingers because that way you get more coverage. Now for eye makeup, I am prepping my eyelids. So for that I used my Maybelline's concealer and that is in the shade 20. I think it's sensible. So I'm just taking out some powder, that is Maybelline Fit Me powder, and that is in the shade light medium. I'm just going to set the eyelids lightly using the same powder. For eye makeup today, I picked up my Rose in the Air palette from Wet n Wild. So I'm just going to lightly build up my crease. For that I'm using the transition shade from the palette. So this palette can be used in different ways. So today I am going to use this to create my soft foxy eye look. So now I am just going to take an angular brush and I am just going to define the foxy line. For that I picked up at first the dark brown shade from the palette and I am just going to draw roughly a wing and a kind of foxy wing that is a bit of extended. So here girls, you do not need to be very precise because at the end we are going to be smudging this. After depositing the color, I am just going to buff it out so that it look more, you know, smoked out and cohesive. So yeah, that's what I'm doing here with my blending brush. Reaching at this stage where I have a smashed very sharp wing, I am just going to take my liquid eyeshadow from Swiss Beauty in the shade Diamond Dust 02. So the liquid eyeshadow will provide a sort of base for my glitters to stick on. So that's what I did here.
Then now I picked up my Blue Heavens Shimmer Dust, and this one is in variant 05 and it is completely a white, or you may say a silver shimmer dust. So I had a bit of fallout that I dusted off using the small brush. And so to add a pop of color, I decided to go in with the cranberry shade from the Wet n Wild's palette. And with the help of an angular brush, I am just going to draw very closely to my upper lash line a small wing. So now it's time for completing the full face makeup. So for that, I picked up my LA Colors concealer, and this one is in the shade Pure Beige. I have done a full blown review on this and also on the foundation. So if you're interested, you can check that out. So to create an uplifted look, I am taking the concealer a bit upwards, you can see here, and I'm just firstly blending it out using my fingers. Now I picked up my Maybelline's Fit Me foundation, and I am in the shade 230. It's called as Natural Buff, and I'm blending it out using Miniso's foundation kabuki brush. Do not need to rave about the foundation because it is the most inexpensive and the quality product of, you know, the market. After blending the foundation with the brush, I am just going over with a damp beauty sponge, and this one is from Blue Heaven if you are wondering. So this way I am trying to avoid any sort of cakiness on my face, so I am just going over. Now to highlight the under eyes, I am just going to apply a tad bit of the concealer and will just blend it out. It will add some dimension to my face because after the foundation and the base, you know, you can see the face was looking a bit of flat. To set the concealer in place, I am taking my Maybelline's same loose powder. I haven't done baking on my channel yet, so here it is, I am showing how I do it. So I just take a bit of extra powder on my sponge and I just place it under my eyes with the damp beauty sponge itself. And since today we are going for a foxy eyeliner look, so I'm going to take the powder upwards because earlier I have applied some concealer there also. After waiting for 2 minutes, I am just going to dust off the excess of the powder from my face and the under eye area. So that's what I'm doing here. So guys, the purpose of baking is to provide you a creaseless and a finished, you know, under eye area. You can see it for yourself, and if you like it, you should definitely try it and let me know in the comment section, or you can tag me on Instagram. So now it's time for brows, so I'm just doing that. I'm just following my natural brow shape. I don't like to do it like Instagram thing. So here what I did, I just used my Miniso brow definer and some brow product that was also from Miniso. To complete the eye makeup, I picked up the same cranberry shade from the palette and I'm just blending it out on the lower lash line. And to smoke it out further, I used the deeper brown shade. Now to provide the face bit of more dimension, I picked up my Wet n Wild's Mega Glow Contour and Highlight Palette, and that one is in the shade Dolce de Leche, and this brush is also from Wet n Wild, and I'm just lightly going to contour my usual areas like the cheekbones, the jawline, the nose and a bit of forehead. Because I don't have a big and large, you know, forehead, so I don't require much of forehead contouring, but I just do it anyway to make it look more cohesive. Blend out the contour I placed, I picked up the bronzer brush and I'm just blending it out nicely. Now it's time to put some color back on face. For that, I am using Wet n Wild's Pearlescent Pink, one of the famous blushes from Wet n Wild. Now it's time to glow. So for that, I picked up my Maybelline's Master Chrome Highlight in the shade Molten Gold. This one is a beautiful gold color. And earlier, I have also used the Rose Gold one variant from the same. So now I am just placing it all over the usual places like the cheekbones, the mid of the forehead, the bridge of the nose, the tip of the nose, and keep it bow. Guys, you can definitely build this highlighter up to a full blown, you know, highlighting effect, and also you can shear it down for a natural finish. So to complete the eyes, I picked up my color bars, just Marsala Kajal, and I just popped it in my lower and upper waterline. And then after spritzing some Plum's Green Tea Mist on my face, I am just going over all again with the same damp sponge. Now to curl my lashes, I picked up my L'Oreal Lash Paradise Mascara. So here I am just coating my upper and lower lashes with the same mascara. You can see how nicely it coats your eyelashes, and also it separates your eyelashes, gives you very voluminous and fuller look. And definitely I'm going to pop up some falsies today, because this look kind of demands for some extra drama. So this one I used from Pro Arte, and to fix that I used Pack's Lash Fixer. Now you can see it for yourself that how falsies change the game. So now it's time to moisturize the lip again. So today I am thinking to just go monochromatic with my eyeliner. For that I picked up a Lakme's Bullet Lipstick from Primal Plus Matte range, and this one is in the shade Cocoa Credit. So guys, surprise surprise, first time ever I'm just going to pop on some gloss on my lips. Now you can see how it is really complementing the look. I really loved it, glossy lips and sparkly eyes. So I'm just going to clean the contour area. That's it for the look, guys.
So guys, I really hope that you like this video, and if you do, not forget to like, subscribe and share this video with your family and friends. Also comment down below what do you want me to do next. And I will see you in my next video. Till then, take care. Bye.